What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Modded Mondays, and today we got three different mods. I think two of them are from CJ's Plenty Parts, and another one's from a different website. But nonetheless, let's get to it. Let's check out what we got in the magic box. So we did get a Mustang RTR shift knob with gray lettering. Full white. So it didn't come with the jam nut. So instead we're going to be using the locker. I bought the removable one. Hand tool removable, and it also says medium strength, blue. Other one is red, and you need your special tool and heat and stuff. To pair with the beautiful white shift knob, we got a all black reverse lockout. I think the black will really complement the white. It would kind of just give the shift knob a floating look to it. This comes with two zip ties, I think, or just one. This comes with one zip tie and a little rubber band thing. Since we're already taking off the shift knob, might as well do the whole thing. And last but not least, we got the Mustang GT350 start stop button. We're gonna go from the silver to the all red. Some tools for this one. To install this one, just unplug the negative terminal. The other ones, I have some flathead screwdrivers to pry at this center console. Let's get to work. Got something. I'm fucking pulling up on my screen from Okay. Okay. Oh no, I did break it. Great. That's just great. Oh wait. No, I'm ruined this. Apply some tension. All the pins, and it's just sprung out. This is the part we're replacing. It's two different pieces, so if you break this taking it off, or if I break this taking it off, I don't care about this. Now this thing's supposed to go back down. I just put between this and here in this crevice and just twist it up. I didn't care if I was gonna break it, so I just went for it. I broke a little bit of it, and that's it. All right, this doesn't fit all the way through, so cut one seam at a time on both sides until it goes all the way in. Okay, now we got this through. Let's pre-thread it. go above this one. All right, so we're gonna do, we're gonna count the amount of turns you get. We're gonna go like this, around the hole. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 and a half. So at 10. Right, so 10 spins.
It's TrueMentals.com.
Do it again and we're gonna stop at 10. One, two, three, four. 5, 6, 10. You're gonna want to let this cure. I'm gonna be driving, unfortunately, because I still have to go to work. But hopefully, maybe I'll take this with me and undo it at work and put it back and leave it for 8 hours. If I have to stay for 12, even better. But we'll see. Now we're gonna do this. We're gonna unplug. We're gonna go unplug the negative terminal and we'll be back. This should all turn off. All right, so see, apparently in these corners right here, you're supposed to pry and it should come out. So we'll see. I only have a tiny flathead screwdriver. I don't have a pick. Just don't wanna break the actual fucking, I just pushed it back in. 2, 1. And you just push that on. Okay. All done. 3 of them are installed. If you guys did enjoy today's video, don't feel free to hit that like button and subscribe down below. And subscribe for more content just like that. Modern Mondays and Car Cruising Fridays so far. If you guys want me to upload anything else, if you guys are interested in seeing anything else on the car, just comment down below.
Yes, you are. I don't know why you don't. Why? No, huh? Why are you not? Yes, you cry all the time. Yes, you cry all the time.
Maybe in a little bit. Maybe we can go over there a little bit.
No, not right now.
Yes, you wait. What a dramatic bitch. If you guys are interested in seeing any other mods, please let me know. I guess you could say this week was 3 mods under $100. Might be doing some more interior mods next week. Anyways, guys, happy Modern Monday, and we'll see you guys next time. Happy modding.